Hello and welcome to this video where we look at how to build a search in NewsWhip Spike. We'll cover how to add a new search and how to refine it to meet your needs. By the end, you should feel confident to build your own search unique to your role. Searches are a key foundation of NewsWhip Spike. Without them, your dashboards and widgets will be empty. With them, you are able to get the most accurate data as quickly as possible. The three ways to build a search are by keyword, by source, or by URL. A keyword can simply be a word or topic you want to follow. The search will find everything about it. A source could be a social media channel, such as a Twitter account, or a subreddit. And a URL is simply a website you want to track. Both of these sources are real, incidentally, and good for baking recipes. I'll share them in the video description. Now, searching with keywords is the most versatile and the way you may find yourself using the most. If you're familiar with Boolean searches, then you'll be able to create queries that are more targeted. For example, AND can be used to narrow down results with only those that mention all of the keywords being presented. On the other hand, OR can be used to expand results where you want to include two related but potentially separate keywords. It's also possible to exclude results. Perhaps you're adamant that brioche should be regarded as a pastry. Let's now jump into the product to build the search. Okay, let's start with A for Apple, the technology company. I think we covered enough food. I could choose to start from scratch with a custom dashboard, but I'll select Monitor as I want to see everything across the web and all major social networks. I'll start by just typing in Apple. Now it's a single keyword, so I can just type it as it is. As you can imagine, this is going to cast quite a large net. I can anticipate articles or posts or tweets about product updates, product launches, stock value, and even possible controversies. I'll expand out our web articles widget to take a closer look. So really, I've now created a search and it works. I could save it and move on. However, at a glance, I can see some things I may wish to refine out of it. Now, as Apple is a global brand, it's likely they will be mentioned in many headlines in other languages. I can see that there is a popular article here in Dutch, which isn't one of my strongest languages, to be honest. Therefore, I'll refine the search to only include results that are in English. I could also choose to only include results that were published in a location, such as North America, or I could choose to exclude a location such as Oceania. Perhaps you don't care for any news about Apple in Australia or New Zealand. I'm happy with the location, so I'll leave it for now. Glancing back at my new results, I've decided I don't care for any news about Apple TV or any of their shows. No offense to you, Selena Gomez. I can edit my search to exclude all references by adding not. I need to put this in quotation marks as it's searching for a specific word combination or an exact phrase. We can see that our results have now been updated. Let's look at some other filters. The default search range for the keywords is in the headline and summary. However, you can choose to reduce or expand this. Search headline only is a good option for a large company like Apple when you only care about them being the main focus of a story. On the other hand, search full article is best for a particular phrase or a niche product or reference. So searching the full article for Apple is actually going to be a bit of a nightmare for this search. We can see that the top article is about a football, soccer match. I checked the article and there's only one reference to Apple within it. So I'll select headline only. We can see in our update the top story is about how Apple's new crash detection feature is being triggered by people riding roller coasters. It's a popular story and we can see there are 94 similar articles. This group similar articles feature is enabled by default for such occasions. It can be disabled but is best reserved for when there's a lot fewer results to shift through. Again, we have a Reddit filter to expand the search into the comment section, if you dare to do that. All these filters are best utilized to refine results, and so these other options are really best used as a backup when you're struggling to find something in particular. Perhaps your eye has spotted something else that stands out here. But yes, it's that time of year where Americans love to make lots of pies with apple and cinnamon and all the lovely spices. You will come to find that recipes have incredible levels of engagement and interaction. So this is a good opportunity to showcase the last filter, which are categories. The most obvious one to include here is tech, but as we'll see, this will only include technologically focused sources. You can also choose to exclude certain sources. We can see our top Facebook post is some sort of competition entry. Again, I've decided I've no interest in Gcash, so I'll exclude this page. This can be done with a website as well. There are quite a lot of Apple product leaks or similar content generated for clicks, so perhaps you could exclude that. Sometimes the practice of building a search helps you determine what you really want to track. In this instance, I'll wipe it and choose to focus on two current products I care about. So now I'll get all the results that mention the Apple Watch or iPhone 14. The only thing I'll choose to filter this time is the language. I'll quickly save the search and we'll see it's created a new dashboard for me. I could choose to add new searches to this, either competing products or perhaps others focused on Apple stock or future events as an example. I now have a best practice suggestion before you start building your searches. Now you can tweak your searches as you go, but now is a good time to determine your searching goals. Do you want to monitor trends in your industry? Do you want to compare competitors? Do you want to track yourself? Or are you a marketing consultant in the pharmaceutical industry and you want to track a specific drug? Answering these questions now will help you build your searches out for your dashboards. We'll look at the widgets available to you in the next video. Thanks for watching.